Let's get to know our world. What is 6G mobile communications technology? Even before the 5G mobile communications standard was fully deployed, the eyes of many started to turn towards the next generation, the 6G wireless communications system. Although the 5G mobile communications standard is still in the early days of its deployment, ideas are starting to come to the fore to consider what the next generation, i.e. 6G mobile communications, might look like. It is perfectly normal to start looking at what 6G technology might include because the technology for 6G will take some while to develop. If 6G is to be able to meet the needs of the mobile communications when it is launched and for some while afterwards, then it will need to use up-to-the-minute technology which is not available at the moment. However, there has been talk that 5G will be the last mobile standard released as such. This will be updated to provide the required performance improvements, and in this way it overcomes the huge investment required to launch a completely new system. If this idea catches hold, then 6G will not be named as such, but instead it will be a major improvement in 5G performance to meet the needs of the ongoing mobile communications or wireless communications users. What is 6G mobile communications technology? Definition. In terms of a definition of what 6G technology might be, it is probably a little early to give an exact definition. What can be said is that 6G, or the sixth generation wireless communications system, is the successor to 5G cellular technology. It is anticipated that 6G networks will be able to use higher frequencies than 5G networks, and this will enable higher data rates to be achieved and for the 6G network to have a much greater overall capacity. A much lower latency levels will almost certainly be a requirement. Overall, it is expected that 6G mobile technology will be to support 1 microsecond or even sub-microsecond latency communications, making communications almost instantaneous. Timescales for 6G. 5G started its deployment in 2019, and it is anticipated that it will be the major mobile communications technology up until at least 2030. Initial 6G deployments might start to appear in the 2030 to 2035 timescales, although this is very much a rough estimate. However, these timescales for 6G roughly fall in line with those for previous generations. 1G was available in approximately the 1980s, 2G in the 90s, 3G started deployment around 2003, and 4G initial deployments started in 2008 and 2009, and finally 5G in 2019. In order that 6G technology is available in time, initial ideas need to start coming together about now. 6G technology developments. There are already a number 6G technology research projects looking into what might be possible and also what might be needed. The actual format for 6G will depend on how 5G develops and where its shortfalls appear to be. Currently, there are many different use cases that have been put forwards, and only time will tell what the uptake is and how 5G is used. It is expected that it will be used increasingly for the Internet of Things, IoT, as well as inter-vehicle communications for autonomous vehicles. The way all of this pans out remains to be seen. If there are shortfalls in 5G, then these can be included in the 6G proposals. In addition to this, one of the areas that is expected to be a key element of 6G is terahertz communications. Using these exceedingly high frequencies, huge bandwidths will become available, although the technology is not available to make this happen. 6G development projects. There are already a number of 6G technology projects that are underway at the moment, and some organizations are now starting early development. South Korea Electronics and Telecommunications Research Institute. As might be expected, South Korea is well ahead, and this institute is conducting research on terahertz band technology for 6G. They are hoping to make 6G 100 times faster than 4G LTE and 5 times faster than 5G networks. The Ministry of Industry and Information Technology, MIIT, China, with China investing large amounts into technology, they are keen to gain a lead in 6G. Accordingly, MIIT is directly investing and monitoring the research and development process. The University of Oulu, Finland. This university has started a 6G research initiative known as 6Genesis. The project is expected to run for at least 8 years, and it will develop ideas that will be suitable for 6G technology almost to 2040. USA initiatives. The USA is planning to open up 6G frequency spectrum at frequencies between 95 GHz and 3 THz for early research and development, although this will require approval from the Federal Communications Commission FCC for frequencies over 95 GHz GHz to 3 THz. Technologies for 6G. 6G mobile communications technology will build on that already established for 5G. Some of the existing new technologies will be further developed for 6G, millimeter wave technologies, using frequencies much higher in the frequency spectrum opens up more spectrum and also provides the possibility of having much wide channel bandwidth. With huge data speeds and bandwidths required for 6G, the millimeter wave technologies will be further developed, possibly extending into the terahertz region of the spectrum. Massive MIMO. Although MIMO is being used in many applications from LTE to Wi-Fi, etc., the numbers of antennas is fairly limited. Using microwave frequencies opens up the possibility of using many tens of antennas on a single equipment becomes a real possibility because of the antenna sizes and spacings in terms of a wavelength. Dense networks reducing the size of cells provides a much more overall effective use of the available spectrum. Techniques to ensure that small cells in the macro network and deployed as femtocells can operate satisfactorily are required. Many new technologies will also be introduced. Some candidates that are being talked about could include the following. Future PHY, MAC, the new physical layer, and MAC presents many new interesting possibilities in a number of areas. O waveforms. One key area of interest is that of the new waveforms that could be used for wireless communications. OFDM has been used very successfully in 4G and 5G mobile communications as well as a number of other high data rate wireless communication systems, but it does have some limitations in some circumstances. Other waveforms could include GFDM, generalized frequency division multiplexing, as well as FBMC, filter bank multi-carrier, UFMC, universal filtered multi-carrier. Each has its own advantages and limitations, and it is possible that adaptive schemes may be employed, utilizing different waveforms adaptively for the 6G mobile communication systems as the requirements dictate. This provides considerably more flexibility for 6G mobile communications. Multiple access schemes. Again, a variety of new access schemes are being investigated for 6G techno modulation. Whilst PSK and QAM have provided excellent performance in terms of spectral efficiency, resilience and capacity, the major drawback is that of a high peak to average power ratio. Modulation schemes like APS-K could provide advantages in some circumstances. APS-K has a much lower peak-to-average power ratio, PAPR, it lends itself better for mobile communications systems better as the final amplifier can operate more efficiently the lower the PAPR. Duplex methods. There are several candidate forms of duplex that could be considered for the new 6G wireless communications system. Currently, systems use either frequency division duplex, FDD, or time division duplex, TDD. New possibilities are opening up for 6G, including flexible duplex, where the time or frequencies allocated are variable according to the load in either direction, or a new scheme called division-free duplex or single-channel full duplex. This scheme for 6G would enable simultaneous transmission and reception on the same channel. What's the difference between 5G versus 6G? 1. 5G and 6G use two different parts of the spectrum. Both 5G and 6G take advantage of higher frequencies on the wireless spectrum to transmit more data, faster. However, 5G occupies broadband frequencies at sub 6 GHz GHz and above 24.25 GHz, called low band and high band frequencies respectively. 6G will operate at 95 GHz to 3 THz THZ. At those wavelengths, 6G will deliver speeds 1,000 times faster than 5G, which is only 4 to 5 times faster than 4G. 2. 5G makes the Internet of Things possible, 6G speeds it up. Part of the reason 5G is so anticipated lies in the expectation that it will finally make the Internet of Things a practical everyday reality. The frequencies used by 4G are too narrow and too crowded to transmit data at the speeds that smart devices need to function optimally. That's why they haven't gained widespread traction. That's going to change with 5G, and likely again with 6G. 3. 5G will not replace 4G. 6G will not replace 5G. While 4G was 3G but faster, 5G and 6G represent different iterations of wireless connectivity. Many predictions expect 6G will be reserved for business, military, and industrial purposes with some consumer uses such as immersive entertainment. It won't be practical to have every device streaming with 6G, but other advances may change that. 4. 6G opens new frontiers of connectivity, but 5G doesn't. 5G has struggled to arrive because of its infrastructure requirements. In contrast, 6G will build on the infrastructure we put down for 5G and enhance connectivity, on land, under the sea, or even in space. 5. Both generations have very low latency. Latency refers to the time it takes for a packet of information to transmit over a frequency. 4G latency is about 50 milliseconds. In 5G, that drops to 5 milliseconds, about 10 times lower. 6G latency is estimated at 1 millisecond, a latency 5 times lower than that of 5G. That almost instantaneous speed will help make massive data transmissions possible. 4G versus 5G versus 6G, more than just evolutions of wireless technology, 6G means more than just faster speeds and more data transfer, although those things will exist. When we consider 4G versus 5G, we can see how wireless technology has evolved. It becomes more nuanced when considering 5G versus 6G, but that may just be because the technology remains a decade in the future.